down, me children, and I'll tell a story of the mountains in the days when guns was law. When two families got disputing, it was bound to end in shooting. So just listen close, I'll tell you what I saw.
Oh, the Martin and his boys, they were reckless mountain boys, and they took a family feud when they'd meet. They would shoot each other quicker than it took your eye to flicker. They could knock a squirrel's eye out at 90 feet.
All their fighting started out one Sunday morning, when old Grandpa Coy was full of Mountain Dew. Just as quiet as a church mouse, he told in the Martins' hen house, 'cause the Coys, they needed eggs for breakfast too. Oh, the Martins and the Coys, they were reckless mountain boys, but old Grandpa Coy is gone where angels live. When they found him on the mountain, he was bleeding like a fountain, 'cause it punctured him till he looked like a sieve.
After that, they started out to fight in earnest, and they scarred the mountains up with shot and shell. There was uncle's brother's cousin, why they bumped them off by dozens.
Just how many bit the dust is hard to tell. Oh, the Martins and the Coys, they were reckless mountain boys.
At the art of killing, they become quite dead. They all know they shouldn't do it, but before they hardly knew it, on each side they only had one person left.
Now the sole remaining Martin was a maiden, and as pretty as the picture was as great, while the one surviving boy was the handsome Henry Coy, and the folks all knew they'd soon meet face to face.
Oh, the Martins and the Coys, they were reckless mountain boys.
But their shooting and their killing sure played hard, and it didn't bring no joy to know that Grace and Henry Coy both had sworn that they would finish up the job.
So they finally met up on a mountain pathway, and young Henry Coy, he aimed his gun at Grace. He was set to pull the trigger when he saw her pretty figure. You could see that love had kicked him in the face.
Oh, the Martins and the Coys, they were reckless mountain boys.
But they say their ghostly cussing gives them chills, 'cause the hatchet sure was buried when sweet Grace and Henry married. It broke up the best darn feud in these here hills.
Let's rehearse it again, Ford. This time, put more feeling into it.
How can I put any more feeling into it with all three of those hillbillies over there making all that noise?
I'll stop them.
With all this confusion, I can't even think.
Is that unusual?
You may think this is where the story ended, but I'm telling you the ghosts don't cuss no more. 'Cause since Grace and Henry wedded, they fight worse than all the rest did, and they carry on the feud just like before.